Ali Care and Amphia. And if you're new here, remember to hit that subscribe button, comment, and share this video with your friends and your family. Now, I want to get to part two of this video. I'm so excited. So many people have emailed me and asked me, what are some of the food that is good to eat, especially when you decide you're going on a diet? Now, one of the things that I noticed, I have a tummy that, oh my God, it's so hard to get rid of it. You want it flat, you don't want to do any surgery. But guess what, guys? You might say you're going on a diet and you eat something, but by the next hour you're hungry. Couple minutes after, you just get hungry, and that's not good for you because you think that you're eating less, but you're more eating often. So it's good to eat stuff that will stay in the stomach, that will give you less fat, and also good for your system. So I'm gonna give you three types of food that you should eat, and I've written them down so I don't make any mistakes. So if you see me looking, that's what I do. Okay, all right, so we're gonna talk about food that can digest slowly. Now, you definitely want food to digest slowly if you're trying to lose weight. Now you're saying, am I gonna have food settling on my stomach and don't digest? That means I can't sleep, I'll have an upset stomach. That's not what I mean. I mean food that will stay in your tummy and you still feel full, knowing that it's not doing any harm to your body. And these foods are, so if you have your pen, you can just go get it and write them down, or you can watch back the video. And these foods are like vegetables, and we're looking, it's not all vegetables that don't digest slowly. So we are talking about the one that digests slowly, and the vegetables are nuts, dairy, and that is if you're not lactose intolerant. And we have corn, carrot, cabbage, and apple, and I'm talking pineapple here. Now, whole wheat bread, and we have peas, and we have beans and cashew. So if you want to make a meal from that, that is good, because a lot of meal can make from all of this that I just mentioned. And if you eat that, it will still let you feel like your tummy having food while it give you no fat. It just helps you to also burn fat, making your body feel good and energetic. So you also want to eat things that keep you energized, and of course it's less sweet. The only thing there that will give you sweet is like the apple, and you know you need a little sugar. So from the fruit is okay to have a little sugar, so that's okay. Now I want to get to the food that are digesting moderately, and food that digests moderately is for the people who don't want to gain any weight, and still at the same time you want to keep that shape and that body, and you don't want to lose any weight. So you would look for food like this to eat and to make your meals of it. And these are like sweet potato, pumpkin, banana, melon, and of course banana. Did you know that if you eat a ripe banana in the morning, it will make you feel full till lunchtime? All right, so those food are food that will stay in your tummy like for 2-3 hours. You want food to stay in your tummy for at least 3 hours if you're trying to lose weight, for moderate amount of time, 2.5 hours before you eat again. You must can have a healthy shakes after 2 hours, don't gain any weight, and still living healthy. Now, food that digests so quickly, and this is going to surprise you. Have you ever been to a Chinese restaurant? We'll go to Chinese restaurant, we have so much food on the table, and as you know, rice is their course meal. No, yeah, rice, shrimps, and as you finish eat the food, by the time you go in the car, go to the bathroom, freshen up and reach home, you're hungry again. And what that is going to do, that are going to let you get fat. So food that are quickly digested is not good for you. You want food that is hard to digest, stay in your tummy, don't give you a lot of fat, and help your body. And let me tell you, food are like this: rice, milk, Milk is not suitable for weight loss, might I add. I did mention milk in the first where I said it digests slowly, but you have different types of milk like soya milk and all of those milk. But I would stay away from milk if I'm trying to lose weight, but you still need some calcium, so you can add a little, like maybe once a week, to your diet. And other food that are hard to digest and will stay, that are quickly to digest and will cause you to want something to eat again, is like chips and nuts and other food that are easy, the other food that are quickly to digest are like chips, like for instance you're eating a banana chips, cereal are easy to digest, and you find out that you have to mix the milk with the cereal. So while you're mixing the cereal and the with the milk, it digests so fast and you're hungry again, so you have to eat. There's a little thing that I have to tell you. You like KFC and Burger King and pizza? Well, guess what? Pizza. Did you know that most of people who want to lose weight, they are afraid of eating pizza? But guess what, I'm telling you, you don't have to be afraid anymore. But and when they buy the pizza, they will take less topping, meaning they just take the dough and the cheese and that's it. And they said to themselves that, okay, this is actually better for me because I don't have a lot of toppings on it. I'm telling you, that will easier to get you fat. The pizza is better when it's full of toppings. Yes. So it better the pizza have a lot of topping with the vegetables and the all of those nutrition facts, the onion, the garlic, all of those things are better for you when the pizza have those, because it's giving your body nutrition, and what it does, it helps to break down the dough faster. So you know your body break down the food, but when you have vegetables with your dough, it break it down faster. And just try it and you will see. So when you're avoiding a certain types of food because you don't want to put on weight, maybe that food is the food that is also best for you. So start looking at the type of food, research it, and if you Google search it, anything like that, you will find out that there are better ways of eating, looking for the food that stay in your tummy longer and don't give you any fat and help you to be better at your diet plan. Now this is my part 2 video. I will definitely have some part 3 where I'll tell you about the different calories and vitamins and everything that you can find in each food. What can you eat to get rid of the tablets and the vitamins naturally? What can you do to sustain yourself? And what can you do to make sure that you're eating the right food for your body type? Because what worked for me must work for you. And that's what people need to understand. You will see so many weight loss ideas out there and so many workouts, so many gym workouts and everything. But if your bone structure, your body type, your health wise, it don't work for you, then you're gonna have a big problem if you're gonna try everybody else method. You will have to find one that works for you and stick to it and tweak it as you go along to make sure that if your body is changing over a period of time, you're changing with the food that you're eating. Because you can start a diet plan and you have to change it over a period of time. Try to take do your cholesterol check often as possible, and also do your diabetes test. And if you don't have diabetes, check your glucose level, because you want to make sure that you're not adding and you're not taking away. Also, if you're diabetic and if you suffer from pressure and all of those things, anxiety, certain foods are good to stay away from and certain foods are good to take. So even though we will have the food that digests slower, sometimes it's not really good because of what you're suffering from. Maybe you have low blood count, you have to eat a lot of greens, and you have to stay away from a lot of other food products. Maybe you have allergies. So find out what is best for you before you start saying that you're going on a diet and you just pick up somebody's diet sheet and you start working from it. And my advice, as always, when you decide that you're going on a diet, the first thing you should do is get yourself checked at the doctor first. Go to the doctor and do a checkup. Once you do a checkup and find out that everything is okay with you, find out your cholesterol test, your blood count level test, your sugar level test, find out all of those things, check your calcium, everything, if you are okay, and then you can start to look at the type of food that will match your health situation. So this is Ali Kier. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. Please like, share, and comment. And if any of my tips are helping you, let me know. And if you even have some pointers for me, you can email me or you can just comment below and we can talk about it. This is Ali Kier. Stay tuned for part 3 video.